غير كده نفضل نشتغل. الدولة ما بتعملش شعب، الشعب هو اللي بيعمل الدولة. بناء البلاد جهد وعرق وإخلاص وأمانة. أنا أتحدى أي حد يقدر يعمل اللي إحنا بنعمله ده في 10 سنين.
Welcome back. And now it's time for our press review. We are going to take a look at the main headlines of our Egyptian dailies. It is a pleasure to us to have with us today Mrs. Vivian Moros. She is a political commentator. First of all, good morning and welcome back.
Good morning. Thank you.
Right, we have a lot of things actually, many different headlines to bring you more details about it. And moving on, or let me start by reading the banner of Al Wafd newspaper. President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi has extended a state of emergency in designated areas of the North Sinai governorate for 3 further months. The most recent extension was made during the dangerous security circumstances that the governorate is facing, and the emergency measures are to be applied in areas including the region from the east of Rafah Hill to El Auga west of El Arish. The decision, which was initially to be applied on the 29th of April, will take effect after Parliament approval. The renewal of the state of emergency had previously been applied automatically as the country was without a parliament since 2012. A nighttime curfew from 7 p.m. to 6 a.m. will also be imposed in these areas, though El Arish and the international road from El Medan checkpoint and the entrance to El Arish city from the west will see a 4-hour curfew starting from 1 a.m. until 5 a.m. or until further notice. And the decree states that any citizen found in public during the curfew hours will be imprisoned according to 1958 law. Mrs. Vivian, how do you read this and how important it is actually? Because definitely over there must be a state of emergency due to all what is going on over there.
Yeah, but I think there was already a long time state of emergency since they started the war on the terrorist groups in Sinai. And definitely with all what's happening around, there is more, we have to be more alert to any probability of more troubles there.
And let me take both points of views, because some people who will talk about emergency measures or such a state is not going to be a good atmosphere. But again, we have to take a look that it has nothing to do with the stability of the country at all.
It affects the people living there. And I think they will be happier to feel that they will be safer in a few months' time than being under the stress of having those terrorists around. I think they'll be welcoming that with great pleasure, because they know that this is
looking for more peace.
It's done for their security and for the security of Egypt accordingly as well. It's not just for there. So I think the people of Sinai actually are very mature population, because they've been helping with the wars all over the wars in 67, in 73, all the time. They've been part of the fighters' front. So I think they're very mature.
They've
regarding
always been on the front.
Yes, yes. And they're protecting us as well.
Moving on to Al Ahram newspaper to take a look at another headline. President Sisi received on Wednesday the South Korean Minister of Trade and Industry, Jo Hong Won. This visit comes as a follow-up to President Sisi's visit to South Korea in March, and it will help raise the bilateral ties, according to the presidency spokesman, Hala Yusuf. Won asserted that the keenness of the Korean firms to increase their investments in Egypt, and the South Korean delegation will participate in the meetings of the Egyptian-Korean Business Forum that will kick off on Thursday. Back to the visit of President Sisi actually to Korea, and this is one of the important visits. And we always say that we are waiting to cultivate the crops after the visits actually that took place by President Sisi. And here we can see this. I believe this is another important meeting.
It's a very positive step, because it's a reciprocal, it's returning the visit with very quickly, because the visit was very recently in the past few months, and this could have waited for a year or two, but it's been very fast to prove that the relations are really getting stronger. And Egypt is a very big market for the Korean products as well, apart from a lot of other things, because all the countries in the whole world now are fighting terrorism, and they have to get together in a stronger way to be able to fight these terrorists and to prevent it from coming everywhere. So, because every country who doesn't have any terrorism will learn from other countries how to prevent it from coming to them. So, all these relations covers a lot of aspects of the daily life. And I believe maybe they'll be opening some more industries to have the Korean products made here in Egypt with the bilateral help from both countries. So I expect that this may happen as well as a result of this visit, among other things as well, of course.
Moving on to another headline, and actually this is one of the most important issues that is dominating most or if not all of our press today, actually. And moving on to Al Masri Al-Yom, President Abdel Fattah al-Sisi is going to witness wheat cultivation on Thursday in Al Farafra, where the president launched the 1.5 million acres project. He will give the go-ahead signal to start cultivating 7,500 acres within the first stage of the project. And for his part, New Valley Governor Major General Mahmoud Ashmawi said that this project represents a qualitative transformation for the governorate. How do you think, or how do you perceive all of this? And definitely this is one of the most important mega projects, and this is a national security. Let's put it like this for Egypt.
Of course. Because one of the main problems and issues for the Egyptian government was the wheat. To be able to nourish all our population. And we were always...
Actually, it has always been the source of
the
our
source,
life.
Because it's bread.
Ancient civilization.
Yes, it's the bread. It's the basic. It's the wheat for the basic things for everyone. And all the 90 million are eating bread from the wheat. So it's the most important product for the Egyptians. And we used to spend a lot of money and a lot of foreign currencies to be able to bring it from all over the place. And we had problems of unfit for eating some. So now we're having our fresh, our Egyptian product made here in Egypt, which is a wonderful thing, and we'll be saving a lot of foreign currency. And now, which is very important, because all the deficits that we're having is mainly because this is one of the elements that causes the deficits of the Egyptian budget. So it will improve tremendously, and maybe as well, hopefully, we'll be able to export it as well, some of it, because I guess they're having a lot of preparations for that by building the storage areas for all these wheat, because we never had this storage area. So we had a lot of waste as well. So we will not have any waste now. I think there is a policy of limiting the waste of everyone, which is saves the country a lot of money, because by giving everyone the amount of bread that he needs.